a very, very extremist ideology within Islam. This is a sect, the same sect which has given rise to the Taliban and Al-Qaeda. All these Al-Qaeda, Taliban people belong to a specific sect of Muslims. They don't belong to Ahlus Sunnah. They don't belong to Sufi path of Islam. They don't belong to mystic and Sufi interpretation of Islam or the Sunnah interpretation of Islam. They belong to a very narrow, I don't want to name them, you can understand, a very narrow extremistic interpretation of Islam, very, very narrow. If you find all over the world, wherever these terrorists and militants are working, they belong to same origin, with same faith, same theology. None of them ever has emerged ever from other school of thought. So the question is, because they are against the shrines, they are against Sufism, they are against spirituality, they are against celebration of Maulid, celebration of the birthday of Holy Prophet, and they are against the spiritual traditions of the Muslim community. The only difference is, some people, those who are known to be non-violent extremists, non-violent extremists, they sit behind, they provide them theology, they provide them encouragement, they encourage them morally, theologically, they encourage them academically, but they themselves don't go and fight on the front. So they are their supporters, they sit in the mosque, they sit in the madrasas, they work with the governments. And let me say that we won't be able to eliminate these things unless we start our counter-terrorism or counter-extremism war right from non-violent extremism.